of Carl Romo and Albert Martinez Jr. Carl, who was my grandmother, my mother, passed away in 1987, and our father passed away in 1991. And they had 10 children, 5 boys and 5 girls. Rosie was the first of sisters to pass away. And unfortunately, we had 2 brothers that passed away in recent times. Felix passed away in 1970, and Albert passed away about 4 years ago. So I'm number 7 out of the 10. And growing up, I didn't know Rosie that well because we grew up in foster homes. So I spent probably about 12, 13 years in foster homes. And when I went back to live with my mom, a couple of the sisters, I didn't even know they were my sisters. So it was a big surprise. I didn't recognize Norma. I didn't know she was my sister. And a couple of them, I didn't know. But I guess I just found out that Rosie was in a foster home too, and I had never known that. But you know what? God puts us in different places for a reason. And if you look at what's happened with her family and everything down the road, you can see that she was blessed in spite of things that happened in her life. Rosie had a common law marriage with Chewy Estrada for about 28 years, and before they decided to go their own way. But in the meantime, they had 6 kids. A whole bunch of them, they're all here. So Rosie raised 6 beautiful kids, and those kids had, of course, their own children. They had grandkids. So Rosie, with her 6 kids, Rena was the oldest. She had 7 kids after that. I mean, 7 grandkids. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, so you had 7 kids. Debbie had 4. Sean had 4. Tony had 1. You had 4. You. Tommy had 2. So these are all grandkids. Let's see. I guess with great grandkids, Robert from Rena's side. Robert had 4 kids. Crystal had 5. Robin had 2. Jeremy had 1. Then with Debbie, Rosalind had 3. Bobby had 1. Darlene had 3. John has 2. And then there were great grandkids, or was it great. Okay. Junior has 1, and Ryan has 2. So that made her a great, great grandmother. What a legacy. I think I counted, I got up to like 46. And I think I missed a couple somewhere, so you could probably round that out to 50. That's a family tree in itself. But what a legacy. I just remember in younger days, I mean, after I came back with my mom, that Rosie was, she was with Chewy, and we would go down and have parties and see her all through the years. Alfred and I were, the stinking old brothers from South Central LA. We would go down and hang out with her sometimes, go to house parties, be with the kids when they were small. We had a good time. And in even in recent years, Rosie would go to dances with us. I wasn't much of a dancer, and Rosie, as you can tell, she liked to dance. And then, of course, she would come down to the house with Caroline, and they would come and pick up my wife and take off to the casino and leave me at home. Sometimes I could tag along. I would just go at once and come back or something. I wasn't really a big gambler, but they sure did like that casino. stuff that I'm missing as far as and my hope is that the family sticks together and remember where they came from, that you take care of each other, love each other, okay? That you respect each other, and that you don't forget your mom, your grandmother, your great grandmother, because that's what she really wanted. Put our differences behind ourselves, and let's just go on with life. I want to read a Psalm 62. It says, "My soul finds rest in God alone. My salvation comes from Him. He alone is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will never be shaken. How long will you assault a man? Would all you throw at him down this leaning wall, this tottering fence? They fully intend to topple him from this lofty place. They take delight in lies. With their mouths they bless, but in their hearts they curse. Find rest, my soul, in God alone. My hope comes from Him. He alone is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress. I will not be shaken. My salvation and my honor depend on God. He is my rock, my mighty rock, my refuge. Trust in Him at all times, O my people. Pour out your hearts to Him, for God is our refuge. Low-born men are but breath, and the high-born are but a lie. If weighed on a balance, they are nothing. Together they are only a breath. Do not trust in extortion or take pride in stolen goods. Though your riches increase, do not set your heart on them. One thing God has spoken, two things have I heard, that you, O God, are strong, and you, O Lord, are loving. Surely you would reward each person according to what he has done." And when I read that, it reminded me of a story. Actually, a sermon that I heard recently. And it kind of starts with the story that most of us have heard about. And it's the story of Moses. And most of us have seen the movie. Okay, Moses took the Israelites from slavery and hostile being, in a foreign country, and took them to the Red Sea. We all know the story, the Red Sea parted and the Israelites escaped Egypt. And they were supposed to go to the Promised Land. Well, the Israelites didn't do what they were supposed to do. They brought a curse on themselves. So God said they had to stay in the desert for 40 years. And the reason why they were in the desert for 40 years is because they didn't trust in God. They were starting to gripe about things and talking about going back to Egypt. They were having pagan worship and whatever other things they committed. They brought a curse on them. So the Israelites wandered in the desert for 40 years. And the reason was God wanted that whole generation to die, because the next generation coming on was the generation that was going to go to the Promised Land. Even Moses, he may not have gotten it from the movie, but Moses was not permitted to go to the Promised Land. He died before he got there. But what Moses did is one of his aides named Joshua, Moses blessed him, and he was the one that carried the, mm-hmm. to